quick intro on the Kaiser Shift frame. I've been skating the last couple times. If you checked out my last two videos, you've seen I've been skating with the freestyle block in. Today I'm going with the Fluid 5 style H-block groove. If you're unfamiliar with the Kaiser Shift frame, it comes with three different H-blocks that you can switch out and change out your grooves anytime you want to. So again, the last couple times I've used them with the freestyle style block, this has the Fluid 5 block, so I can roll flat. So that's what I've done today. I'm rolling the 56 millimeter dead wheels, flat all the way across. I was going to do a high-low setup with a 55 in the middle, 60 on the outside, but it's very tough to find a wheel profile that matches with a 55 and a 60. So I decided to go ahead and go with a straight flat 56 millimeter 92A setup all the way across. So again, my last couple videos, I've used a freestyle block in here, which worked out really well for skating actually the sledge and some other street spots. I'm pretty excited to try this out. I'm typically an anti-rocker skater myself, so this could get very interesting watching me skate flat. I don't do it very often, but I wanted to give it a shot since I had the frames. I want to see what they're capable of with all the different things. So, so I'm going to get to it, get moving around. It's cold out, so I want to get my body moving. The longer I sit around, the stiffer I'm going to be. So let's get to skating.
Too much for my flights, I pay way too much for my clothes. I'm just too damn cool for these hoes. Someone please just hand me my phone so I can get back into my zone. Everyone just leave me alone, I'm just way too lit for this.
All I ever wanted was a handful of hunters. All I ever needed was a girl who could see it. Gold on my neck, boy, I ain't trying to flex, but I'm shining so hard even blind people see it. Stepping out the wagon, it's 200,000. Bright red paint got it looking like a dragon. That's what you get for my hard dead trapping. I'm lit, Minnesota's just splashing.
Don't that shit sound familiar? Lame ass rhymes these rap dudes deliver. Can't trust y'all, I stay live, familiar. Knock down walls, nigga, break down the pillars. Hands to the ceiling, hands in the air. Spread that wealth on them bands everywhere. Material chitting on royalty. Suck this dick, baby, I'ma shoot gold in your hair. Turn everything up. Turn everything up. Welcome to the land of the greed. Welcome to the home of the slave. Run up in your house while you sleep. What's the number to the motherfucker safe? Niggas going from the cradle to the grave. You done fucked around and stumbled in the cave. Back to gold, Django, one chain. Girls do anything to get best age. Turn anything up. Money ain't anything but pops tell me how to sack green up. Black King Tut. High school friends selling drugs at the same house where I grew up. That's how you really get back to your community. I don't settle for less, I'm getting what I need. I know people locked up for only using weed. How did Hillary Clinton get immunity, huh?
I don't know why that's funny.
Every day is Halloween, huh? Michael Myers, Jamie Lee, huh? Freddy Krueger in your dreams, huh? Load up clips and make a scene, huh? They putting lies on the screen. Black and gold, everything. We going crazy, we jump around like Marines. We rage against the machine. Nigga, we the kings. You ready? Turn everything up. Turn everything up. Hey.
All right, I'm done for the day. It's starting to rain out here. Still like 32 out. Supposed to get some wind remix coming in. Get my first session on the flats, shift flats. I'm gonna pop these off and I will finish this up at home. All right, hello. I am back from the skate park, back at my house. The weather was getting bad out. It was about 32 degrees out, starting to sprinkle a little bit. So I tried to get in as many tricks as I could before the rain started to set in, before it got too dark and too cold. But I really wanted to get out and test out these frames here. So if you've checked out my last couple videos, you'll see that I've been skating the Kaiser Shift Unlimited frames. And if you're unfamiliar with the Kaiser Shift, they are three different frames in one. So what that means is they come with a removable H-block. You can take out the center bolt right here, pop out the H-block, and you have three different styles to choose from right out of the box, to customize your setup on the go. So you can take extra parts with you and set it up however you want to. But the last two sessions out on these, I was using the freestyle H-block. And basically a freestyle H-block means there's no center wheels, and there's grinding blocks in place of the wheels. So they call it freestyle without the center wheels. It also has an H-block that comes with them where you can put in anti-rocker wheels for some hard wheels in the center. But on this particular outing, I wanted to do the flat setup. This is modeled after the Fluid 5 made by Kaiser, this H-block. I will tell you, the setup was, it was fun tonight. But as far as getting them set up, I was trying to figure out how to do this and still enjoy it. So I'm typically an anti-rocker skater at heart, anti-rocker or freestyle. That's always been my favorite go-to. So whenever I try a flat setup, it's kind of intimidating to me at times. So I was trying to find a good way to set these up. I was looking at doing a high-low setup. With these, you can actually rocker the axles up and down. I don't know if you can see, but they will move up and down so you can change your wheel sizes and your positions. I've got these rockered all down right now. With the 56 millimeter 92A dead wheels. Again, I was trying to find a good high-low setup. I was going to do 60 millimeter on the outside, 55 in the center. But you'll find when you go try to do a high-low setup like that, it's hard to find wheels that match each other. So typically your 55s have a flat profile similar to these right here. But then when you get into your 60 millimeters, they're usually a little more rounded. So what happens is your edges on the center wheels touch before the outside and gives you kind of that kind of banana feeling, swivel feeling. That's not something I wanted to do. So I chose to go ahead and do all the same size wheels all the way across. And again, I rockered them all down towards the boots so I'd have a lower center of gravity while skating. I did have some concerns that with that being a real short setup and a smaller wheel that I would catch on the sides of the frames. But I'm here to tell you, I tested it out before I started skating around. I tried to get the boot down on the ground to where these would touch, and they simply did not catch anywhere. I didn't feel the H-blocks touch. So I was afraid of washing out on these, but I did not get that even with 56 millimeters. So very happy with the frame wall width. And it's skinny enough to allow you to put a smaller wheel in here and not rub when you're making a real sharp turn or going over small obstacles at the skate park. So I'm very pleased with that. That was one of my biggest concerns with the setup. So with that out of the way, I was able to just get to skating. Testing these out, again, like I said, I'm typically an anti-rocker skater. So there's always some hesitancy when I'm skating flat. But I was running through all my tricks tonight. Hit them all one after another, no problem. The boot down with this H-block is a little steeper than with your typical freestyle frames or anti-rocker frames. It just means that you have to get down a little farther because the H-block's taller in the center. But overall, it was pretty easy to adjust to, and he did a few grinds and it felt fine. I didn't lose any tricks as far as that goes, skating flat. And as you'll see, I only got wheel bite one time, and that was pretty much the end of my session. After that, I lost a lot of my confidence, hurt my confidence, hurt my emotions, to be honest. It was rough. Good thing I was wearing shin guards, because I took a pretty bad shinner on that one. But that was the only time I had wheel bite the entire night. Every other grind I did was flawless. And the wheel bite I did have was more than likely my own error. It's not putting my feet down in the right place, but if you lose track of what you're doing and get too confident, skating has a way of fighting back and showing you who's boss sometimes. So it's always be humble when you're doing your grinds, always be mindful of how you're doing your grinds, especially when you're riding flat. When you least expect it is definitely when your center wheels will get you, and it got me tonight. But other than that, overall, I had a really good session on these tonight. Had a lot of fun, with the setup here. But just kind of show some other flat frames that I have and kind of do a quick comparison. I would say these are pretty similar to the Wish frames as far as the H-block design. These are a high-low frame, but the groove is very similar. The wheel bite protection is very similar on this frame compared to the Kaiser Shift here. They are about the same center height when these are mounted down into the sole plate groove. So there's not much difference here. It's really just a matter of, at that point, if you like to do different size wheels. The good thing about Wish frames, you can do two different size wheels. Typically they are 7 millimeter difference. So for instance, if you have a 65 millimeter wheel on the outside like I do here, you can have a 58 millimeter on the inside and you'll roll flat. Same thing with the shifts here. You can actually do a high-low same way, but there's a 5 millimeter difference when you have these rockered the opposite direction. So you can do like a 60 and 55 and still roll flat. But a lot of people like the Wish frames also because of the larger wheels if you want to roll faster. But then they are very beefy in the middle. There's a lot of plastic there. So if you're used to getting boot down really easy on a regular aggressive frame, it might be a little more of a challenge to get fully booted down on these and these as well. So just keep that in mind. So with being an anti-rocker skater, I've always had a mission to try to find a flat setup that I really, really liked. And over the years, my favorite one that I've found so far has actually been the Master Blade frames here. They are a good cross between an anti-rocker frame and a flat frame. That being said, they are a high-low frame, like the Wish frames are, and like the shifts can be. We've got bigger wheels on the outside, smaller wheels on the inside. I believe, if I remember right, these are a 13-millimeter difference. I think these are 60-millimeter on the outside and a 47-millimeter wheel on the inside here. Wow, I knew that difference in size giving me a huge split in the H-block. The Master Blades are the closest thing I've ever found to an anti-rocker frame, but also gives you that that flat ride also. And you have different options for your center wheels here. These are an actual urethane wheel, not like your typical hard anti-rocker wheel. These are, I believe they're 92A, even 90 or 92A, but they are a softer urethane. They're just like a regular wheel. But you can also put in harder style anti-rocker wheels in here as well if you want a full experience of not having to worry about wheel bite at all. Anything will slide if you put like a harder wheel in there. So with that being said, I've had a lot of people ask about these different flat setups. So I'll probably be revisiting these Master Blades again here soon in the future, especially after trying these out a couple times. I'll do a comparison on these to kind of get my feelings with the, upfront honesty. I'd say that the Master Blades have always been my favorites the last couple years, and I would like to revisit those again soon. But again, this video here is more on the Kaiser Shift. As far as these go, for what they are, absolutely love them so far. No major issues. I loved having the freestyle block in. They slid really well, work well on concrete, work well on ledges. These work really well too. Unfortunately, I slipped up and got a little bit of wheel bite and paid the ultimate price for it. But up to that point, I was having a great time on these. Cruising around the park, going fast, smooth. The only drawback I have with skating flat, and I think a lot of people get kind of cornered into the idea that you need hard wheels all the way across. These are 92A, like I said. I would kind of like to try these with a softer wheel. For me, if I'm going to have wheel bite, I feel like I'm going to have it regardless. So the hardness of the wheel, I don't know, is going to save me a whole lot. Whether it's a 92A or an 88A, I think I'm still going to stick. But the overall comfort level, I think, might be a little better with a softer wheel. So I think I'm going to revisit this same setup but with a softer wheel all the way across. I'm curious to see how it feel, if the performance or if the overall feeling feels better. Again, a guy like riding flat, but I feel like they're a bit hard sometimes and they just feel a bit quick clacky because of that hardness of the wheel. So I think I will try these with a softer wheel all the way across, like an 88 or maybe to do a 90, somewhere in the middle, to see if it changes my feeling on how well they perform. But as far as the setup goes, very, very pleased with it overall. So again, as always, please leave some comments, comments below, like the videos, but comment what you want to see. If you've had any similar experiences on these frames or other flat frames, you know, let me know what you think about the wheel hardnesses. You think 92A is good, 95A is better, or, you know, 90A is better. Let me know what you think about the wheel hardness, because I'm kind of curious about that myself to see, experiment with that, see if there's some better ways to roll up the setup. But overall, again, very pleased with this. So please leave some comments below. If you got some other ideas, whether it's about these frames or other skates, again, I've got a pretty large collection of skates, frames, wheels. So I've got a good chance I might be able to put together a setup that you might want to see or try something else. But let me know. I always love trying out new skates and skate parts. So let me know what you want to see, and I'll see if I can accommodate that and get it on the channel. But other than that, I've been having a blast with this channel the last few weeks. I'm new to this. Don't have too many people on here just yet, but hopefully I can build a following and create this channel for the skaters out there. I've been skating 28 years now, so I've got pretty good experience on different products over the years, what I like, what I don't like. I've got a pretty good idea when I get something, if I'm going to be pleased with it or not. So it just comes with trial and error over the years. So. Again, if there's something you want to see me test out, please let me know. And there's a good chance I either have it or could possibly get it to try out for y'all. But other than that, you know, thank you all for tuning in. Again, please like these videos if you do like them. Check out my other videos I have on the channel as well. And I definitely look forward to making more. Just let me know what you want to see. I'll see what I can do to make some, that spark your interest or help answer some questions for you. Again, if you got any questions on anything, please drop them in the comment section and let me know what you think. But other than that, thank you all and everybody have a good day.